Yo, what is up, guys? It's your boy Frish is back here for another video on GTA 5 Online. And of course, we're going to be doing a glitch today. And this is going to be the updated version of the Give Cars to Friends glitch. And yeah, I'm pretty much going to be showing you guys how to do the glitch. And I'm going to list the requirements very quickly. So the giver is not going to have any requirements at all. All the giver needs to have is just a car that they're going to give to you. As receiver, however, if you're receiving the vehicle that is being given to you, you need an arena workshop or a nightclub. And you guys are also going to need an MLC with Bay 3 personal vehicle storage. And that's pretty much all you're going to need for the requirements. Essentially, you make a duplicate of your friend's car. So it is a dirty dupe. So if you want to use this glitch to dupe cars, I really recommend to not do it unless you and your friend have the same exact custom plate. Then you can dupe cars that way. But I really recommend not to do this because I don't think the process... I mean, it's easy to do, but I just really don't think it's worth duping. But... I mean, at least you know it's consistent, but it is dirty dupe. So, like I said, this is a give cars to friends glitch, not a duping glitch. There have been any solo dupes except the one I uploaded almost about a week ago. If you guys want me to, I can make an updated video on that. I can make it quicker, nicer, and I can just give more extra tips on how to make it consistent. I know there's a couple glitches. I think there's like two or one other car duplication glitch that I know of that actually works with friends. You need a friend, but I don't know if I should upload that or not, if I should make a video on that or not. So comment down below if you guys want to see an updated version of the solo car duplication glitch I uploaded a week ago. Let me know if you guys are interested in seeing the car duplication glitch that you need a friend on. It's not like those glitches are too hard to do, but they do take quite a few steps and they do take a little bit longer. But sadly, there's no easy, you know, dupe glitches right now, no easy money glitches. Yeah, other than that, let's get straight into the video. Alright, so to start off the glitch, obviously you're going to need to be in your Arena War Workshop. You're going to want to have your friend be in the same session as you. It could be a friend session, invite only, don't matter. But have them start up a job. And once you get to this elevator right here, you're going to want to hover over the garage level. It doesn't really matter which garage level, but you're just going to want to hover over one of these. At this point, your friend's going to be in a job and you can join him through the friends list or through the party, whichever way works for you. But you cannot join in game. You got to do it through the party or friends list on Xbox or PS4. But right here, I had to slow it down very, very quickly because I couldn't record this part with my Elgato. I didn't have my Elgato. But essentially, I joined my friend through the party. And very quickly, when you are joining your friend, and you're gonna get like a getting sessions details little loading icon at the bottom, as you see right there. You're gonna want to keep spamming X as soon as you get that, because you're accepting the alert and you're also choosing garage level, the one that you're hovering over. You end up spamming X and choosing the garage level and accepting all those alerts. So it's a very quick step right here that happens, but you just gotta spam X. But essentially, you go into a blast screen, and if you did it correctly, you end up going into the job actually. But when you're in a job, at this point, all you have to do is just leave the job. You know, your friend's gonna be in this job too, so you and your friend both leave the job. And if you did the step correctly, you guys are gonna spawn back in your Arena Workshop. Right here, you see me glitching back, and I had selected the B1 garage, and I loaded it into my B1 garage. Like I said, that's how it works. You guys might wanna need to, you know, rewatch that part just in case. But get in your ISI once you're back in your Arena Workshop and drive it out. And when you drive it out, you're gonna wanna drive it a little bit, and then from that point, you're just going to want to back all the way to this blue circle. And I'm going to slow this part of the video down too, because you hover over, you know, the garage level that you had taken your car off from, and you press X and you spam triangle. So when you spam triangle, you go into this weird ass, you know, gray screen, and it makes it look like you're parachuting kind of. But you're pretty much going to spawn on the street. And when you spawn in the street, essentially at this point, pull out the interaction menu and just kill yourself. Once you guys commit suicide, at this point, you're going to want to make your way to this one location here on the map. And you're going to want to make your way to this location because this is where we're going to be doing a glitch. I'm going to get out the car and make my way to this pink house over here. And I'm going to just call out my MOC. Most likely, if you're standing this way on this like pink house right here, the MOC is going to spawn behind you. As you guys see, it spawned behind me on the map. And this is where it spawns. You guys are going to want to park it exactly like this. I mean, just leave it like that pretty much. So to get your minimap back, go to this blue circle behind the MOC and press circle to decline, and you get your minimap back. At this step right here, all you guys have to do is order a free elegy, you know, a car, and we're pretty much gonna have your friend get in the car. At this point, make sure you and your friend have both of your cars set to passengers only, but right here, you're gonna wanna have your friend press down on D-pad and select a story mode character so that they get an alert. And they gotta sit on that alert, because what you're gonna do next is you're gonna go up to the MLC, press right D-pad, and it kicks your friend out. and you back away very quickly. And at this point, you get out of your LG and you press down D-pad, you select Franklin, you deny that alert, and you do it one more time, because at this point we're gonna enter our MOC. Right here, it didn't let me enter my MOC because my LG was too close. But when you enter your MOC alone, you get this black loner screen. And I did not realize that I was supposed to press down on D-pad and select Franklin again so I could get my, you know, alert screen from the story mode, you know. But you decline that alert and it's gonna make you turn invisible. And basically, at this point, you enter your friend's vehicle. And when you enter your friend's vehicle, it's just gonna spawn you straight into the MOC. And at that point, you have a, you know, duplicated car of your friend's car. Your friend keeps his car, you keep this car. It is a dirty dupe, so do not sell it. In order to save the car, you're gonna want to exit your MOC, switch outfits, and then go to creator or just find a new session. And when you do that, essentially you're saving the car, then you can just go back into the same session you were just in, and pretty much your car is going to be saved in the MOC, and that's how you save the car. But it is a pretty cool glitch that you can do with your friends. But other than that, that's really all I got to say for this video. Hope you guys did enjoy. Leave a like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.